Hey guys, today I have another printer to show you. It's made by the Tear Time company. I used to use their printer, a Plus 2, and they sent me another printer. It's called Cetus. So I think it will go smoothly because I have a lot of experience using their printers. So now let's unbox it. I need another chair because it's a DIY printer, so it has a lot of parts. I can't just, you know, lay it on the floor. So let me grab another chair. So on the top they have instruction. It's all in English. Oh, and they have Chinese at the back too. Looks like it comes with the assembly tools and all the instructions for software. Okay. And they are all PLA filament, blue and white. And USB cable. And the PT, I think this is the PTFE tool. And a cutter, like the one I used on my workbench. It comes with this aluminum extrusion, just like the one I normally use. Spatula. And some screws, more parts for the printer. Power adapter. So this is the extruder. There's a 3D printed part on the top. I guess this is direct drive because I don't see a Bowden tube on it. And this is their fuel plate. And these are all the other printer parts, XYZ axis. Now I'm going to assemble it, and let's put all this stuff away first. Okay, now let's try to level the bed. I already downloaded the Cetus app. The link is in the instruction. Just go to their cetus.com software, you will find it, and download it according to your computer. They have the iOS version, they have the Windows version. So let's turn it on and see. Okay, now we are in the app. So let's hit print, and printer not initialized. So let's go to the free icon, the third icon here.
So printer is ready. Let's level the bed. Let's go to the calibration. Okay. But not so high right now. It's 183.36. So let's try. I'm going to move the nozzle down to the build plate. Before that, we are going to put the paper underneath. And now let's hit plus and try to move it as close as I can to the bed. So let's go to the center, number 5, and let's move it down a little bit. Yep, moving. A little bit snug, but not too snug. So now number 5, the 5th point is, I set it to 0.4. And let's move to number 9. So close to my camera, let's move it closer to the left. So after we level the bed, let's try a test print. I have some filament over here. So the print is finished. Let's take it off and take a look. It looks good. Now let's try something more difficult. So I printed out a lot of prints and I fiddle around with it a little bit. I changed the temperature and stuff, but these are the prints I want to show you guys. This is the Benchy Bowl I printed at 0.2, and everything looks fine. Like, it's the layer line is fine, but on the top you can see it's a little bit under extrusion. So I also printed out a lot of other small objects, and it turns out all looks like, you know, that this. But for the big prints like this one, you can see it doesn't, if you are going to try to utilize the whole bag, it just doesn't work out. when I was this print takes about 10 hours, and as it goes up, it's under adhesion. The layer line started to fall apart, and I used different filament too. This is dense for Polymax sending me a couple rolls of filament, and I would say it's the best filament I've been using, and so it has nothing to do with the filament. It's the best filament at the market. And I was switching back to the normal filament I was using, a little bit cheaper one, so the quality is not that good. And the same thing happened when I was trying. So this started to fall apart as it goes up. But my verdict is for a $300 printers, it is a decent value. It prints out the box for the small objects, but for large objects, you have to spend some time on the forms. I'm sure you can do some troubleshooting and change the settings, mess around with the configurations. You have to do some compromise. I mean, it's a $300 printers. If you're looking for a more reliable printer, you are going to spend a little bit more money on that. But it doesn't mean it's a bad printer. So my fault for the Cedar printer is it is a good printer, but for a $300 one, you can utilize the whole bed and there will be some problems. You have to spend some time on it. Just keep that in mind. And thanks a lot for watching. Remember, if I can do it, anyone can do it.